Hello friends, once again welcome back in my YouTube channel, and this is the continuity of the previous video. In the previous video our topic was how to use the select statement in Oracle, and again we are going to continue with that. Some clauses there it's remaining. So now we are going to start with the select statement once again. Okay, so this is how in the previous session our we just focused on where condition, order by. Now we are going to start with group function. What exactly the group function is? We are going to start with group function. What exactly the group function is? Group function is also known as aggregate function in Oracle. It's also known as aggregate function in Oracle. This is really important. Now, group function means what? It works on the group. It works on the group and return single value. That's why it is called group function. It works on the group and return single value. As for example, suppose we are using select max of cell from EMP. What we are getting? We are getting the maximum salary from the EMP table. This is the field we are having, select cell from EMP. In this particular EMP field, salary field, 5000 is the maximum salary that we are getting over here. Select max of cell from EMP and we are getting the maximum salary. The same way, suppose we are using select mean of cell from EMP, we are getting the minimum salary. Suppose we are using select average of cell from EMP, average of cell from EMP, we are getting the average of the salary. Suppose we are using select sum of cell, we are getting the sum of the salary. Suppose we are using select count star from EMP, it will display number of record in EMP table, and we are getting the number of record. It's 15 records are there that we are getting. So this is how we can use the aggregate function. This is also known as group function. It will return single value for a group. We are getting the minimum salary among all the salary from the EMP table. We are getting the average of the salary, we are getting the sum of the salary, we are getting the counter star, we are getting the number of records over here. One important thing is that this group function, it's avoid null value. It's avoid null values. Suppose we are writing select count star from EMP. We are getting the count of complete record in the table. Suppose we are going to use select count of com from EMP. We are getting 4. Why we are getting 4 only? Because when we go for EMP table, in EMP table, this is the commission field. These records are null over there. So it's not going to count the null. So aggregate function always ignore the null values. That's we need to remember. Suppose one important thing is there before we will go for the group by, the null value I need to discuss over here. Null values in Oracle, null is the special value that again it's required the special treatment. To get the null and all, suppose we are using select star from EMP, where com is null. Is null is the operator. We are getting the list of all those employee where commission is null. So is null is the operator. We cannot apply equal to null. For that, what we need to use? We need to use is null. Suppose we are using is not null. It's going to display all those records where commission is not null. So this is null and is not null that we need to take care. The third thing is, suppose I'm going to use select ename comma cell comma commission comma cell plus com from EMP, and I'm going to use the alias name over there as total salary, total underscore salary. salary is 800, commission is null, and what we are getting over here, it's null. 1600 plus 300, it's fine, we are getting 1900. 1250 plus 500, it's again fine, we are getting 1750. But the problem comes when it has to calculate with the null. 800 plus null, we are getting null. 2975 plus null, we are getting null. So that null we need to take care. And how we can do this, just we have to write select ename comma sell comma commission comma sell plus commission. Now I am going to use NVL, NVL of com comma 0. So it will replace the null value with 0. So NVL is what? It's a function that replaces the null with 0. Yeah, now this is perfectly fine. In Oracle, always we need to remember, if null is there, we need to take care. If I am going to calculate like total salary, I am going to calculate. Suppose I am going to calculate total marks. If any calculation is involved over there, always we need to consider the null. If I am going to apply the order by, always we need to consider the null. Otherwise, it will create the problem. So we need to take care about the null. And the simple thing is, like we can use isNull, isNotNull and NVL. Other functions are also there with the null. I will discuss that in separate topic that will be related with the functions. Now, suppose we are going to use select count star. Suppose we are going to use count of com. And suppose we are going to use count of 1 from EMP. My question is, what is the output of this command? Select count star, I am going to use count star. It will count the number of records in the table. So you will get the total number of records. It's 15 over there. Now, count com, commission, it will just count all the values that's available with the commission. It will ignore the null value. So I expect it's 4 or 5. And the next one is interesting. It's count 1. It will again count star and count 1. Both are the same thing. Count star and count 1. Both are the same thing. It's not only 1. We can put 2, 3, 4, 5. Any, we can give any numeric values over there. That's not a problem. But the thing is that count 1 and count star both are the same thing. It's going to return the same result. Remember, I will discuss that. So regarding the performance tuning, it's related with performance. When we have to use count star and when we have to use count 1. Remember, count 1 is always better in performance in compared to count star. Because when we write count star, it will go with the each individual values. Then it will count and you get the result. Like when we use count 1, so count 1 is always better than in compared to count star performance wise. So you need to take care, in the place of count star, always we need to write count 1. That will be better for the performance. Now we are going to use group by. Group by is what? It's for the grouping of the similar category of the data. For grouping of record. Suppose this is the table we are having. Now, what I am looking for, I want to count the number of employees job wise, like clerk, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 clerk is there, salesman, 1, 2, 3, 3 salesman is there, manager, 1, 2, 3. So what I need to do, I just need to display number of employees job wise. My question is, display number of employees job wise. So how we can do this? I am writing select job, because I need to display number of employees job wise. So I am going to use job comma, because I need to count number of employees, means I need to apply the count. So I am going to apply the count over here, count star from EMP. Now we need to use group by, because I am looking for the grouping of the records. So I am going to use group by based on the job. Now the result is clerk, 4 clerk is there, 4 salesman is there, 1 president is there, and 1 employee is there without any job, and again the analyst is there, total number of analysts is 2. So this is how we are getting this record. Select job comma count star from EMP group by job. Suppose my question is display number of employee department wise. How we can do this? Like we are having different departments over there, like department number 10, 20, 30 and 40. I want to display how many employees are there in department number 10, how many employees are there in department 20, how many employees are there in 30. I need to do that. So how we can go for? I'm just going to write select department number, comma count star from EMP, and I'm going to use group by department number, and we are getting the result. In department number 10 we are having 2 employees, in 40 it's 1, in 20 it's 5, in 30 it's 6. So this is how we can do this. Suppose we are going to use select department number comma job comma count star from EMP. See, we are getting the error. And what error is exactly? Not a single group function, and the star mark is there. It shows that we are not using any group function on department number. Now we need to apply the group function. So I'm going to use group by department number, group by department number comma, because we are having the job also, so we need to apply the group by on job also. Now we are getting the result. In department number 20, total number of clerk is 2. In department number 30, total number of salesman is 4. In department number 20, the manager is 1. So this is how we can apply the group by. Now the important thing is that always we need to take care. Group by is used for grouping of the data, grouping of similar category of the data. And normally with the group by, we use the group function. With the group by, normally we use the group function. So this is the fundamental that always we need to take care. Suppose if we are using multiple columns, some columns having group function. Remember, the line is, if we are using multiple columns, okay, like department number comma job, some columns having group function like count star, the remaining column must be in, if we are using multiple columns, some column having the group function, the remaining column must be in group by. This is the fundamental always we need to take care. Suppose we are using select department number comma count star from EMP. How many columns are there? It's 2. With one column we are having the aggregate function. The remaining column must be there in the group by. Suppose we are using select job comma count. Suppose we are using job comma count star from EMP. Now we are having the 2 columns. One column having the group function. The remaining column must be in group by. So we need to apply job. Suppose we are having department number comma job comma count star from EMP, group by. We are having 3 columns, one column having the group function, the remaining 2 column must be there in the group by. So we need to apply group by department number comma job, and we are getting the result. So this is the basic fundamental that always we need to take care. Normally when you apply the select statement and all, group by is the most complicated things, and this is the simple fundamental you need to apply. If we are using the group function, the remaining column must be in group by. Suppose I am just going to ignore this group by, I am not going to apply the group by on the job, what will be the result? You will get the error, and the error is not a group by expression. Always remember, error is the good thing. If we are getting the error, we need to understand what exactly the problem is, and we are getting the message like not a group by expression. So, and a star mark is there with the job, means we have to use the group by on the job, because we are not using over here. The fundamental was, we are having the 3 columns, one column having the group function, the remaining 2 column must be in the group by. So we need to apply group by department number comma job, and we are getting the result. So this is what the fundamental of group by and group functions. Now my question is, I want to display only those record where count star is more than 2. 2. I want to display only those record where count star is more than 2. So how we can do this? Okay, I am just going to apply select department number comma job comma count star from EMP. Now I am going to apply where count star greater than 2, and then we are using group by department number comma job. But again, it's a wrong answer. You will get the error, because we are using, remember this line, this is really important. Group function is not allowed here. We cannot apply the group function with where. We cannot apply the group function with where. For this, what we need to do? For this, we are having the concept of having. It's not the where condition. For this, we need to apply the concept of having. Having count star greater than 2. Greater than 2, and we are getting the result. Remember, this where, with where we can't apply, with where we can't apply group function. Remember this line, with where we can't apply group function, like max, mean, sum, average, count, we are not going to apply. We can't do this. For this we are having, for this we are having, with having with having we can apply group function. That we need to take care. This is what, this is the difference between where and having. With where we cannot apply the group function, like max, mean, sum, average, count, we can't do this. For this, what we need to do, we have to apply the having, like this. This is what, this is the difference between where and having. This is the interview question. In the interview, always you get the question like this: what is the difference between where and having? And this is the only difference. Having, we can apply. Having, remember one thing, we can't use having without group by. Without group by. So for the having, always we need to remember these two lines. With having we can apply the group function like this, and we can't apply, we can't use having without group by. If group by is not there, we cannot go for the having. Where, the simple thing that we need to remember, with where we can't apply group function, like max, mean, sum, average, count. These are the guaranteed questions for your interview. Always you need to take care. It's clear? Now I am just going to give you some questions, and believe me, there will be some problem with you and you will give me the wrong answer. Suppose this is the question. It's not the question, I am giving you the solution exactly. Select, suppose I am writing, select department number, comma job, comma sum of sal from EMP, where salary greater than 2000, group by department number comma job, having sum of sal greater than 2000. What will be the output of this? My question is, will it work or give me some error? My question is, will it work or give me some error? Remember, we are using where condition with group by. As such, there is no any problem with this select statement. We are just following each and every rules of the select statement. Like we are using having sum of shall. We can use the condition on group function by the use of having. That's what we are using. And we are using where condition. Yeah, we can use the where condition. The thing is that we cannot apply where sum of salary greater than 2000, but we can apply where salary greater than 2000. So that's not a problem. Normally people get confused, like people think it's group by is there, so we cannot go for the where condition. It's not like that. Where condition we can apply with the group by, that's not a problem. But the thing is that the problem is we cannot apply the group function with where. That's the important thing that we need to take care of. Now, one important thing is there. There is the extension command called rollup and queue. This rollup and queue is normally used for data warehousing, for the data analytics and all. But it's again the extension of the group by. Extension of group by. Suppose we are using select department number, comma job, comma sum of shell from EMP. Now we are going to use group by department number. Again, we are getting the problem, not a group by expression. Why? Because we are not using job over here. So we need to apply the job. So I am writing job. And we are getting the answer like department number and all. My question is, I also want to display the subtotal, of like department number 20. I want to display the subtotal on the basis of department number. So for the subtotaling, what we can go for, we can apply rollup. So I am going to apply rollup, department number comma job, and we are getting the result. Like in department number 10, this is the subtotal of department 10, this is the subtotal of department number 20, this is the subtotal of department number 30, this is the subtotal of department number 40, and finally we are getting the grand total. So this is how we can use the rollup command. Rollup is basically for the subtotaling, and the subtotaling will be based on the first column. But the problem is, we are not getting the subtotal on the basis of job. So what I need to do, in the place of rollup, what we can go for, I need to display the subtotal on the basis of second column also. So we can go for the cube. Now we are getting the subtotal, like we are getting the grand total, we are getting the subtotal according to the job, and finally we are getting the subtotal according to the department number. So this is what we are having, a rollup and cube. So finally, this is all about the select statement. Always we need to take care, like select star, suppose we are using select department number, comma job, comma sum of shell from EMP. We can apply the where condition, like where salary greater than 2000. Then we can apply the group by, suppose we are using group by department number, comma job. Now we can apply the having condition, like we are using having sum of shell, sum of cell greater than 2000. Now we can apply the order by salary, suppose order by department number. So this is how we can use this. The problem is missing expression, because we just did the mistake over there. It's comma, just we need to avoid this. Yeah, this is how we are getting the result. So this is what, this is all about the select statement. It's fine. Now what you need to do, these are the questions you need to try. Like I want to display employee name, salary, commission, and total salary of all employee from department 10. Suppose my question is display name of employee, display record from the EMP table whose name contain S. Suppose my question is display number of records whose department is 20 and job is manager. My question is display number of employee who is manager. Suppose my question is display maximum salary, minimum salary, average of salary and sum of salary. Display max cell, mean cell, average of salary, maximum salary, minimum salary, average salary and sum of salary department wise as well as job wise. So this is the exercise question you can go for, and just believe me, this is the most important thing in any database. It's not, I'm not only talking about the Oracle, it's applicable for SQL Server also, it's applicable for MySQL also. So this is the most important thing that we need to take care, and the important thing is always in we need to take care the syntax. In Oracle, the most important thing is the syntax, like select column name from table name, where condition, group by column name, having condition and order by column name, that we need to take care. Thanks a lot for watching this video. And one important thing that is that in case of any questions, any suggestions from your side, just drop your questions or suggestion in the comment box. And just follow, before proceeding for this particular video, you need to go with the previous video. And this is if one important thing, like if you are really getting the things from this video, it's really good for me also. And you can put some comments, you can just give some likes. Thanks a lot. You can share the video also. Thanks a lot. Enjoy the session.